when God is working in us. And it seemed like everybody then abandoned us, you know? And I never forget, I was by myself. Brother, I have come from addiction. God has delivered me. And
come on.
I lost my fiance to murder. I lost my fiance to murder over a moving doll. Over a dolly. Something you remove a refrigerator with. I was on cocaine. I was lost. I lost everything. And everybody that I ever was there for, they abandoned me. And I was in my hotel living. And God told me, he said, baby, in this season, do not become bitter. I did this on purpose. I need you by yourself, because I don't need nobody else talking to you. The thing that I'm going to do in you, and I struggled in that room. I struggled. And I was still doing me, still in my, you know, in the Coles Lane. And brother, when I tell you, I got up one day, I had a man coming over. I was high as a kite. And I, for some reason, I got up to go light a blunt. And I saw myself in the mirror, and God let me see me. And I threw my hands up and said, Lord, I'm tired. You know, I don't even want to do this, because I didn't even feel like I had purpose. And he said, today, if you don't throw that away, call that man and tell him, do not come over here. And he showed me, because you can't handle what's coming. And he gave me the opportunity to see what my life would be like that very day. And brother, I ain't been the same since. But what he showed me is that when in your life, it seems that everything and everyone is upside down, God knows it's his will, because I'm worse off without him.
I was going over the story of Jacob. Jacob was warring from the womb. It says he had a brother named Esau. From the womb, he's struggling. Do you know what I saw there, though? I don't think there was two babies in the womb. I think in his womb, God was birthing the greater him, so he struggled like you and I do with the greater me that I won't let me be. He says that he's fighting from the womb. Who's going to be birthed? Is it going to be me cussing or me praying? Is it going to be me trying to save them or sleep with them? It's not a person that you struggle with. It's your mentality that you struggle, your mindset that you struggle. It's you that you struggle with. He says, at midnight, he decided to go walking. And I know that he struggles in his mind, like many of us do. If I should do it, or if I shouldn't. If I should stay home, or if I should go out. If I should work it, if I should tell them folk I'm done with it. It's at the middle of the night that we find ourselves, I think, crossed between the debacle of the two.
Yeah, and that mental struggle.
He says he came to the field and God met him there. And he began to wrestle with a man.
Yes. Yeah.
If you do the text deductively, where the hell this man come from? You mean to tell me all I had to do was start walking and trouble faces me? You mean the whole time I was in my house, when I was with the concubines, when I was with the hoes and the drugs and the drink, I didn't face no hell. But when I started walking, they started coming out of nowhere lying on you because they couldn't find no bad dirt to say about you. So they just make up anything. That's when folk you thought was going to be with you forever decided to walk off and leave because they couldn't handle your change and your anointing. That's when you start walking, that's when the enemy starts working. But watch what happened.
Yes.
It says God was with him. Now we read that, and so many preachers preach it as if you're fighting with God. Don't be arrogant.
Come on.
As if you're fighting
there
for
you
God.
Go.
Don't fool yourself to think that's a fight you can face.
Hello.
They preach it like there's any man who can handle
God.
The weight of God just being in the same room, ready to wrestle. Don't think you're that big.
Hello.
But consider yourself weak that God saw you giving out this week and decided to come and fight your battles for you.
For
he says,
you.
All you got to do is stand still and see the salvation. He says, when the inner him was killing him, God looked at it and hollowed him. God, hollow
that's
me.
Good. That's good.
Hollow me for the greater me that you want me to be. Hollow me.
Hello.
God, hollow me of every place that I would let sin and temptation and the world and the drinks. And God, hollow me so anything that's in me that's negative, that's bad, that's speaking defeat over me, hollow it out of me. Says he left there with a limp, but he left there whole.
You know, listen, we serve a God who loves us.
That's
he loves
right.
us
that's
immensely.
Right. That's right.
He loves us immensely, and he wants his kids to know that I don't care where you at today. God loves you, and he's accepted you for you, and you can't do nothing in your own ability to get right. You gotta get him. That's the only one who can get you right. So stop saying to yourself, when I do this or when I get here, I'ma go get Jesus. Get him now. I urge you. Get him now.
This is
finna be it. The normal as we know it is over. And these birth pains is strong. And I can't say if it's today or I can't say in 1,000 years. But what I do know is that he's returning.